any other citizens to be heard?
Hi there, I'm Warren. I live on Gorman Road out of the county, but I did get my mail in Bell Austin. 3338 Country Club Road, number L336-31605. Now, back when I started cropping tobacco in Miles County, apparently now we're all supposed to say that when we start talking, I was actually under 18, and at that time I couldn't vote. It's refreshing to learn that apparently now underage people can actually register to vote in the county, or maybe it was just a miscount. What I'm here to talk about tonight is LED lighting. I was reading an interesting article in Forbes where the writer looked up under the Energy Information Agency and the Department of Energy, both U.S. agencies, that apparently if all the incandescent lighting was changed to LED lighting in this country, it would save 18% of the total energy used in this country. Now, that's sort of an interesting number, partly because that's the same number that's supplied by all 100 remaining nuclear power plants. But that's not actually the main point. If you combine that with Georgia Tech did a study about 3 years ago now, saying that a combination of efficiency and conservation would save enough electricity in Georgia that there'd be no need for any new power plants at all. If you, and I'm sure there's some overlap there, but if you combine the two, not only don't we need that new power plant on the Savannah River, but we, you know, Georgia Power can shut down some more coal plants, and they don't need any natural gas. Now, what does this got to do with you specifically? The users of lighting that make the most difference are actually not the individuals with their houses. It's the big buildings that are run by companies and organizations such as governments. So here's an opportunity for the city of Bell Austin to continue their precedent of leading the way, for example, with the solar panels down at the Bud Creek Wastewater Plant. And this doesn't have to be done all at once. And there are actually grants available from various sources to assist with that. Thank you. If you added solar panels, for example, on traffic lights, think of all the money you'd save, a one-time investment, part of which you could get from elsewhere, and savings from there on. Which is the opposite of what Ms. Singletary has to deal with that pipeline. We have a situation where a pipeline company based in Houston and Florida Power and Light, based in Florida, want to pay a one-time fee for right-of-way, for which they will profit ongoing forever. Does that seem right to you? It doesn't seem right to me. And you know, what do we get in Georgia for this pipeline? A 100-foot wide gash through our wetlands, including crossing the Withlacoochee River downstream from that wastewater plant I'm glad to hear you're going to fix with the SPOS money. And it does affect Bell Austin for several reasons. One being, if I'm not mistaken, Bell Austin is the county seat of Lyons County. Anything that happens in Lyons County affects Bell Austin. There are a number of people with major businesses inside the city limits who own land that pipeline will cross. You may be hearing from some of them. I talked to one just today. And you don't know that pipeline is going through Bell Austin. One thing I did get out of the Spectra people, Spectra and NextEra, the parent of Florida Power and Light, are the companies that are really what Saddle Trail Transmission is. One thing I did get out of them is that they have to file two routes, preferred route and an alternate route. Their alternate route is the one that comes right through the middle of Bell Austin. And they also said that FERC, the Federal Energy Regulatory Commission, can choose the alternate route. So you don't know that pipeline isn't coming right through Valdosta. Even if it's not, it still affects Valdosta. Now, one thing you could do, well, I mean, any of you could file comments, that's obvious. But another thing that Valdosta in particular could do as an organization, not only individuals, but organizations can file as interveners with FERC, which gives legal standing, which means FERC has to listen to them. It's something worth thinking about. We don't need this pipeline. It's no benefit to Georgia. There's actually no need for it at all, because Florida may be growing slightly faster, but if you add things like those changing out to LEDs, efficiency and conservation, and then add solar panels, there is no need for this pipeline at all.
Thanks, sir.